दैट इज साइज रिडक्शन. साइज रिडक्शन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड कम्युनिशन और डिम्युनिशन. सो द टर्म साइज रिडक्शन इज अप्लाइड टू ऑल द वेज इन विच पार्टिकल्स ऑफ सॉलिड्स आर कट आर ब्रोकन इन टू स्मॉलर पीसेस. साइज रिडक्शन मीन्स कटिंग ऑफ सॉलिड्स इन टू स्मॉलर पीसेस. द साइज रिडक्शन इज सिनोनिमस टू कम्युनिशन डिम्युनिशन. इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ कम्युनिशन एंड ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ डिम्युनिशन. सो ये साइज रिडक्शन टर्म्स साइज रिडक्शन कॉन्सेप्ट अप्लाइड इन वेरियस इंडस्ट्रीज सच एज फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्रीज फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज एंड मेनी अदर केमिकल इंडस्ट्रीज. इन दिस प्रोसेस इंडस्ट्रीज सॉलिड्स आर कट इन टू स्मॉलर पीसेस ऑफ डिफरेंट शेप्स एंड बाई यूजिंग डिफरेंट मेथड्स. सो साइज रिडक्शन फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट्स इफ यू टॉक अबाउट फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट्स एस्पेशली टैबलेट्स टैबलेट फॉर्मुलेशन टैबलेट पाउडर्स एंड डिफरेंट इंजेक्शंस दीज ऑल कम्स इन द फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट्स. वेयर एज फूड इंडस्ट्रीज फूड प्रोडक्ट्स आर एस्पेशली डिफरेंट फूड प्रोडक्ट्स वी आर यूजिंग फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज साइज रिडक्शन इज अ मेजर एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. एस्पेशली बायोटेक्नोलॉजी कंसर्न वैक्सीन्स रिकॉम्बिनेंट प्रोटीन्स वेरियस अदर कमर्शियल प्रोडक्ट्स आर कमिंग अंडर दिस साइज रिडक्शन. ओके सो एंड बट एट द एंड ऑफ साइज रिडक्शन वी नीड टू हैव अ डिफाइंड साइज एंड डिफाइंड शेप. दैट इज द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ साइज रिडक्शन बिकॉज वी कांट हैंडल हाई अ लार्ज बिग साइज पार्टिकल्स. दैट इज वाई वी नीड टू हैव अ स्मॉल साइज पार्टिकल्स दैट इज इधर इन द सॉलिड फॉर्म और लिक्विड फॉर्म. इन दिस मैकेनिकल यूनिट ऑपरेशन एस्पेशली इन दिस लेसन वी टॉक अबाउट सॉलिड्स हाउ टू हैंडल अ सॉलिड्स वॉट आर द डिफरेंट मेथड्स टू रिड्यूस द साइज पार्टिकल्स साइज. ओके एंड वी कैन यूज डिफरेंट ग्राइंडिंग मेथड्स वी कैन यूज डिफरेंट कटिंग मेथड्स. वेर एज इफ यू टॉक अबाउट लिक्विड कटिंग लिक्विड साइज रिडक्शन वी कैन सी एमल्सिफिकेशन एंड एटमाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट वाई टू थिंक अबाउट पार्टिकल साइज रिडक्शन बिकॉज वी नीड टू हैंडल द पार्टिकल्स वेरी इजीली एंड वेरी यूजर फ्रेंडली. दैट इज वाई वी नीड टू थिंक अबाउट पार्टिकल साइज रिडक्शन एंड ऑल्सो वेन इट इज रिड्यूस्ड द पार्टिकल साइज रिडक्शन हैपन्स द डिस्पोजल ऑफ वेस्ट इज वेरी ईजी एंड वी हैव वेरी गो ग्रेवल साइज पार्टिकल साइज ग्रेवल साइज एंड द ग्रेवल साइज विल बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू कोयस आर फाइन बाई डिफरेंट मैकेनिकल मेथड्स दैट इज साइज रिडक्शन मेथड्स. ओके so in this lesson especially we use four different types of size reduction concepts. One is compression, second one is impact, third one is attrition or rubbing cutting. I will be explaining what is a compression, what is a impact, what is attrition or rubbing or cutting. These all four concepts where we have to use, how we have to use, everything will be explained. And why we need to think about commuted products, size reduced products, what are the properties of that product, and we already know what are the size particle size properties, particle properties, solid particle properties. Okay, so the objective of size reduction is to produce small particles from larger ones. Small particles are desired either because of their small surface, large surface, or because of their shape. Okay, so the objective of any communication is to produce from the larger particles. So what are the properties of any solid particles? The large surface area and the size. Sometimes the size may depends on for the product processing, shape, number of particles. When you talk about large surface area, sometimes to improve the product application, we need to have a small surface area. When you talk about size, the size is very important. Maybe some you can't, maybe you are not accepting a star type of tablet, so you may need only spherical or oval shape type of tablet. So this is all depending on the process, depending on the requirement, the size and shape and number of particles are very important. And how to measure a size reduction? If you we have to think about to measure the size reduction. So efficiency of the operation is based on the energy required to create a new surface. Size reduction exactly means the creation of new surface. New surface will be created, and then that creation of new surface by using various mechanical method, compression, impact, attrition, rubbing. These all four principles will be used, and we will create the new surface. So the creation of new surface can be measured by using size reduction efficiency. So size reduction efficiency is we will be calculating. Surface area of unit mass of particles increases as particle size is reduced. We know that the smallest particles will be having more surface area than biggest or largest particle. That is why we need to improve the productivity or product performance. Sometimes we may need small particles. That small particles can be achieved by using size reduction, or also called comminution or diminution. The synonymous term of size reduction is called comminution or diminution. So when we talk about size, we had a homogeneous particles or heterogeneous particles. Homogeneous particles may not be lead to uniform size products, or may lead to uniform sized products. Uniform sized feed, homogeneous feed, may lead to uniform sized products, or may not be in uniform sized products. What I wanted to say, homogeneous feed may always, at least 70%, we will try to get uniform products. Okay, when we give mixture type of feed or heterogeneous feed, so different sizes of products may be achieved after size reduction, right? Next, I'll talk about, we have different equipment that we will be talking about, but some grinders, some crushers, any type of size reduction equipment, they will be some particular equipment, they may cut the particles depending on our requirement, but some we don't have any control. Different sizes, different shapes, they may cut. So that is also an important thing, what we wanted to process for size reduction, what we doesn't want to for size reduction. That is we have to remember, because some grinders will have a definite cutting size, definite grinding size, definite grinding shape, definite grinding, okay, whereas some they don't have, it's not in our control. It when we give the homogeneous feed or heterogeneous feed, the particles, the products may come in different shapes or different sizes. So ideal crusher or ideal grinder or any ideal size reduction equipment is an actual unit does not yield a uniform productivity always. So whether the uniform feed is there or existed. Next one is the feed to product ratio. if you talk about feed will be the largest size, product will be the smallest size. The largest to smallest size will be generally 10 power 4. 4. Okay, different communized products are we can see, like maybe any type of communized products we can see: polyhedrons, sharp edge, cornered particles. Okay, any particles we will be cutting, like if you talk about any mirror processing industry, so they will be getting the sharp particles, needles. So depending on the requirement, the processing will be taking place. Next one is I'm talking about. So why we have to talk about energy and power requirements in comminution? In energy and power requirement in comminution is very important because the cost of power is a major expense in crushing and grinding. You are creating a new surface area. When we are trying to create a new surface area for the solid especially, so we need to supply some energy, some power. So the power requirement is a major important requirement for the comminution. Okay, so the factors that control this cost are very important. This cost means energy and power requirement cost is very important. During size reduction, the particles of feed material are first distorted, a strained. The work necessary to strain them is stored temporarily in the solid as mechanical energy of stress, just as mechanical energy can be stored in coil spring. An additional force is applied to stressed particles. They are distorted beyond their ultimate strength and suddenly rupture into fragments. This is how a new surface is generated. Let me tell you again, during size reduction, the particles of feed material are first distorted or strained. Okay, then the work necessary are which type of how much strain we have to give to distort or to create a new surface, that will be our cost. So that is why we need to understand what is energy and power requirements in comminution. Okay, and in comminution especially new surface is created. Okay, so since a unit area of supply solid has a definite surface energy, and when we give some heat or energy supply, and it will be converted into new surface, and some heat energy will be released, ultimately the law of conservation of energy will be the same. Okay. Next one is energy efficiency. Size reduction is the least energy efficient unit operation. Least energy efficient means only 1%, very less energy it will be used to create a new surface. And mechanical efficiency is energy delivered, how much energy will be delivered to the solids is 25 to 60%. So this is the introduction of size reduction.